ago, we covered the Steven Spielberg movies. Last week, we started out with Star Trek. So I'm sure you will recognize it is only a natural progression that we start out today's sermon with the Terminator series of movies. This will be my summation of Terminator 1, 2, and 3. It'll be just like the movies, except Arnold Schwarzenegger won't be in it. Although, if you'd like, I could say, I'll be back. Or I can say, I'm looking for Sarah Connor. Do you know where she is? If that helps at all. In the Terminator movies, the machines that we have created rise up against us and destroy, or nearly destroy, the human race. And I was very afraid of those movies because I have a difficulty with technology and machines at times, and I do have this deep seeking suspicion that one day, in fact, the machines will rise up and our own computers will enslave and destroy us. It won't be quite like in the Terminator movies. It won't be that dramatic. It's going to be much more subtle. The machines aren't going to conquer us by force, but by intellect and by cunning. It will be very subtle. It starts out with things like this. The self-checkout at Home Depot telling you what to do and making you feel like an idiot. That's the first step. It took me a lot of courage before I went to use one of those machines. And when I finally did, I stood in the line and I was scanning my items. And I had come to Home Depot to buy a can of stain. And I had drawn a piece of wood from home with the same color stain so that I could match it up against what I wanted to purchase. And as I was putting stuff through and successfully scanning my items, I took that piece of wood and set it down on the counter. Oh, you... Oh, you know! And the machine said, you have placed an unauthorized item in the vending area. Please remove it before proceeding. And I said to the machine, it's just a piece of wood I brought it from. It's my own piece of... You have placed an unauthorized